Our talented lead artist Shirk has been hard at work over the last 3 months overhauling majority of our world map. We've now got a much prettier, much more performant terrain than before. There have also been some changes to the lighting system to make the game look less flat. Shirk has also replaced some foliage that was once a placeholder. Now all of our foliage is made fully in-house, and it looks a lot better than what we had before. We are starting to rapidly build up our points of interest across the world. However, we felt that Endgame needed something a little extra, a little procedural. We have now added procedural bunkers that will be scattered throughout the map. The generation is seed-based and is tied to the server that you are currently connected to. No two bunker locations on different servers will look the same. These bunkers will play a massive role in extracting extremely rare and potentially exotic equipment. There will be named legendaries with a variety of effects that you'll be encouraged to chase after late game. There has not been an art pass on the bunker assets for over a year. All of the bunkers are currently put together by a programmer, and they are likely going to change for the better in the near future. Nomad has also finished his Nera camp from the last development update, and all of the assets associated with it. We're really excited to start spreading these around the world. Certain random areas will also become quarantine zones that will be deadly yet bountiful sources of gear and equipment. Our programmer has added a basic ladder system. You can now climb up any ladder that you see in game. This includes step ladders that you can carry around and place down. These can be used to access vantage points or to gain access to otherwise restricted looting areas. We're really excited to see some of the shenanigans that our player base will be getting into with these. We've now got some new weapons. First up is the AKS-74U. This submachine gun is the little brother of the AK-74. It packs quite a punch and excels at close quarter combat. Our second addition to the submachine gun category is the MP7. Which is a sweet little submachine gun that features a folding stock. When the stock is collapsed, the item will also take up less room in your inventory. Weapons that have magazines attached also take up more room in the inventory. Last, but certainly not least, the shotgun. Our talented animator, the shiny Haxorus, has put a lot of work into the shotgun. It fires 12-gauge shotgun shells, has a capacity of 8 shotgun shells, and is also one of the most modular weapons in the game. We've also tweaked some of our weapon mechanics. Instead of firing bullets from the player's eyes, weapons will now fire from the physical muzzle. This will make it much more difficult to fire from the hip. We're also adding a new pair of Mosin Nagants. We weren't really happy with our previous iterations. They lacked a lot of the qualities that we desire. We feel that these are a much better fit for the game. You can now push back zombies with a melee patch or use a bayonet if your weapon has one. This is to help with crowd control when you're starting to feel overwhelmed by the undead surrounding you. There are now some new melee weapons in the game. In fact, there's now 26 total, starting at the crowbar, the tire iron, a pair of bolt cutters, a broom, a hatchet, an oar, a rake, a sledgehammer, a mattock, a kayak paddle, and much more. Some of these will be moved to a different animation set at a future date. We're aiming for functionality first because we need a lot of these in-game in order to start building mechanics off of them. Picking up items has been refined. There is now a casting time for picking up heavy items, which is influenced by your character's current limb health. Broken hands will ruin your dexterity and make quick tasks, such as opening a flashlight to insert some batteries, a much more tedious task. You can now place items that you're carrying by pressing B, or to place any item, you can use the place option from the item drop-down menu. Certain items will behave as containers once they are placed, and you'll even be able to move certain containers after they've been filled, such as the cooler. Casting time has been added to most actions within the inventory, such as turning a flashlight on and off, opening sub-containers, removing magazines from weapons, and having a good old swig of diesel. There is a new ragdoll state that we've added. It is triggered by going unconscious, or can be triggered manually. We've included the ability to voluntarily fall over, since players can carry players that are in a ragdoll state. You can also use a pistol when you're carrying a different player, however, you will not be able to reload your pistol, so keep it in mind when reaching for your Makarov. Plan accordingly. We've now got a new set of third-person animations that look a lot better than our old ones. We've also got some animations for carrying large objects in third-person. Keep in mind that a lot of these objects will slow you down when you're carrying them. We've made some progress on our medical system by implementing our new limb health system. In Dead Matter, your limb health is currently separated from your blood, which currently acts as overall player health in Dead Matter. Only bleeding will truly affect how close you are to death. However, being forced to walk everywhere due to a sprained ankle is something that cannot be ignored in the zombie apocalypse. Your life depends on it. We've also implemented a nutrition system. While it's not a requirement to fulfill all of your macronutrient or vitamin requirements, there are benefits for doing so, without any penalties for failing to do so, so long as you remember to eat and drink. You can now shoot any jerry can or propane tank item. This also applies to when they are being carried. Keep in mind that damage from these can cause a chain reaction. The same goes for the fuel trailer. We care about our world, and making sure that it feels lived in. We've added a way for you to read newspapers in-game. In the near future, we'll be adding multiple newspaper collections in order to provide a way for survivors to piece together the events leading up to the outbreak. Nomad has helped get a new van ready for gameplay. It has room for up to 4, and can be equipped with some upgrades that allow you to store a ladder and some camping supplies on the roof, or a tire on the back of the van that you can be used to repair it if you accidentally run over a spike strip. We're still working on the mechanics behind this in order to add an element of risk-reward for when you decide to fix your tires. There are now greenhouses which will allow you to grow food all year round. Just keep in mind that they'll likely be a target for bandits during the winter. In the future, we'll be allowing survivors to build their own greenhouse, alongside some additional structures, such as a guard tower and some log wall fences. If you want to get your own road named after you, or get a personalized hockey jersey, all while supporting Dead Matter, head on over to our Indiegogo page. There's a wide variety of ways to support us, and some really cool once-in-a-lifetime perks for doing so. Show us some love via social media, Twitter, Facebook, our forums, and our community Discord, which is extremely active. We're a tiny, no-bullshit team. Our goal is to make a damn good survival game that we actually want to play. And while we're not great project managers, we're good game developers, and we strive to continue to deliver regular updates and interact with our community. Listening to your feedback enables us to make a better game, so please stop by our forums or our Discord. We care about feedback and we listen to it. Thank you for watching this to the end. We truly appreciate your support.
like and share if you enjoy the video and think others might benefit from this. And of course, subscribe and hit the notification button if you are new to the channel and want to be notified every time I post a video.